Welcome back to the Peninsula Fine Arts Center. It's the Wyeths Three Generations, works from the Bank of America collection. And each gallery focuses on a different artist within the Wyeths. So right now we have N.C. Wyeth. In another gallery we have Andrew Wyeth. And then in the last gallery we have Jamie Wyeth. Having this enormous exhibition of over 70 pieces is huge for us. To have it incorporate into all of our galleries is just a coup. Because normally, you know, while we get, you know, have exhibitions on view, something of this nature that's this broad with these three artists that have this wonderful legacy is amazing. N.C. Wyeth, probably one of the most famous illustrators. He actually went to the Howard Pyle School of Illustration Art in Delaware and really became so fascinated with illustrations. This was a time before photography became prevalent, so magazines would always hire these wonderful illustrators to create image for their magazine. So N.C. Wyeth was very immersed in this and would research and would, you know, get costumes and create these wonderful scenes for different books. Rip Van Winkle, Sir Conan Doyle. We have quite a few of the books as well as the original illustrations that are on view. Also in another gallery is Andrew Wyeth. He is most known for Christina's World, which is at the Museum of Modern Art. And he's got some wonderful images. He actually studied with his father. He didn't go to training to a, you know, art institute. He actually learned directly from his father. And so we see a lot of similarities and differences between the two artists. And then the last artist is Jamie Wyeth. He is currently producing a lot of artwork. The interesting thing is that Andrew Wyeth, his father, did not teach Jamie Wyeth how to paint. Another family member did. Again, some similarities, but Jamie Wyeth has more of kind of a whimsical nature in his works. Very vibrant color palette when you look at the pieces. He was also concerned with celebrity and some of the images as far as portraiture. So, you know, I invite you to come and take a look at these three, this artistic legacy of these three, you know, phenomenal artists. The first gallery here is N.C. Wyeth, and he is kind of the first and foremost. He was illustrator of books, and so we have those juxtaposed with the paintings that that we have on display. In the gallery across the way from N.C. is his father, Andrew Wyeth. He, you know, has recently passed away, but he's got some wonderful pieces. He works a lot with watercolor and egg tempera, and he's got, you know, and he's a lot of images of, you know, things that he knows as far as his home in Chad's Ford, as well as they would summer in Maine. So you see a lot of the landscape, those images in his work. One of my favorites is there is an image of Victoria Wyeth, who is the only grandchild of Andrew Wyeth. And she posed for that picture when she was in college. And it's very sweet and enduring. And it kind of speaks to that this is, you know, a wonderful family that, you know, has shown their artistic talents throughout three generations. Then in the gallery that leads up to the backspace is Jamie Wyeth. And you'll see a lot more color infused in his works, his paintings. But again, he's still looking at the landscape, you know, of those kind of family homes within the pieces. The back exhibition, we worked with a contemporary artist, Ryan Lytle. 20 years ago, we had a Wyeth exhibition here. One of the pieces on display was a book called Cabbages and Kings. And this book was actually illustrated by Jamie Wyeth. And we had those pieces on view. We wanted to show them again, but they're in private hands, so we could not borrow them. But we did ask a contemporary artist to kind of reimagine that book. And he's a phenomenal sculptor and does wonderful felt needling, and he made these wonderful rabbits and asparagus and cabbage. And it's a contemporary take on this book. You know, if you haven't read it, I highly encourage you to read, you know, Cabbages and Kings. And then you can kind of get a sense of where he's going with these rabbits kind of surrounding these vegetables and the relationship between the vegetables in the garden. It's quite humorous, and so it's a great kind of take on the book, and kind of a homage to Jamie Wyeth. The PFAC does not have a collection. So we're always changing exhibitions, you know, every, you know, few months. We round out our exhibition schedule with our last exhibition on surrealism. So we have works from Picasso, Dali, Moreau, Lam, and Mata. These are masters of surrealism that we're going to have on view. And then also we have an exhibition on surrealism in children's literature. If you look at Dr. Seuss, The Wizard of Oz, Maurice Sendak, there's some wonderful surrealism in those children's books that maybe people haven't seen or caught on to. So we're gonna showcase them as well, and that'll run in the winter months. And it's the last opportunity to come to the Peninsula Fine Arts Center, so I hope you get the chance to come on by. We're not only open, but we're also having children's art camps here as well. We encourage everyone to come to the Peninsula Fine Arts Center. It's a $1 admission through Labor Day. The exhibition is up until November 8th. We hope that you come and enjoy it with us.